Wellbeing Board. We've obviously got a particular focus on this agenda around the Ethica Fund submission, and obviously many of us have been here this afternoon listening to Chris Han talking about this very subject, so it's it all seamlessly fits together. So I'm just going to do some preliminary. So first of all, do we have any apologies? Okay, great. Item two is just our standing item. Anybody wish to declare any interests? Please say so now. Okay, and item three, minutes of the last meeting of the board held on the 13th of November. I'm assuming you've had an opportunity to read those minutes. Can we agree them as an accurate record? Can I sign them? Right.
Have you found a mistake?
Well, I follow what that says. The support training is your support officers who didn't get check your issues. Mm-hmm. The impression that this training is for officers or not for issues in the state topics. The reason why the position is created is to have another clinical person who wants to support them.
So this is page three, folks, of the minutes. And so should it say clinicians?
Appropriate training is given to clinicians.
Right, so can we just replace support officers with clinicians?
Yeah.
Okay, so with that amendment, can we agree those minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic. Right, okay, so that takes us on to the main item, which is agenda item four. Health and Social Care Integration with Better Care Fund 2014 submission in section 256 outputs for 2013. I think, Graham, are you and Abby going to do a little bit of that?
I'm going to introduce you for them and hand over to Abby. We've also got Sarah Quinn, which I've gathered that have done the absolute massive amount of work involved in pulling this report together. And what they will do is they'll be here to answer any questions and issues, particularly in relation to the detail. Okay, so if I can comment on that.
Yeah, go ahead.
In essence, what we've got in front of you is a number of things. First of all, there's a covering report, which comes from page 11 through to 13. Then what you've got is a better report about the Better Care Fund itself, which runs through page 15 to page 20. And that gives some of the background to enable an understanding of what Better Care Fund is about. Then from page 21 to page 45, what you've got is our draft submission for the Better Care Fund. This is in a template that we're required to complete that goes to the local area team. But this will be a template that we're asking you to sign off as a draft submission, as a final final submission will be to the next Health and Wellbeing Board. And the idea is that we do have a few days after that. There's some additional pieces of paper that have been put around on everybody's place. First of all, there's a pack of financial information. This wasn't ready at the point when we submitted the report, the overview report and draft submission a week ago. So what will also go into that draft submission is financial information, which includes overarching financial information, some more detail about the specific schemes that what you'll see in there is that there's a real focus on the sorts of services that support people either not to go into hospital in the first place or to come out of hospital. A strong focus on the enablement and immediate care. Again, any questions about how we've used the funding and the sorts of services we're focused on, I'm sure that Sarah and Jackie will answer those. finally, the coloured sheet that you've got in places, it is our first draft, and it's coming to me this evening as well, so I'm sure same thing as everybody else. But what we're looking at is in terms of our performance metrics for the Better Care Fund. This would be the basis of the performance dashboard. And what we've got there is our current baseline, basically, where we are now, where we were last year, and what the Northwest is like. So that helps us in terms of setting our targets for the Better Care Fund. And a number of these targets will be related to financial rewards, particularly in 2015. So we've got to be very careful about setting the right targets for these performance criteria. But what we can see is there's some areas that we aren't particularly good at, and some other areas that we're doing better at. So again, there may be some questions about performance and specific criteria. Just in terms of the cover report. We aren't actually integrating the integrated management. So
yeah, can I say that Graham this week won a Golden Bull Award for paragraph. I've got to mention this story. paragraph 2.4, which I've suggested he frames this paragraph. That's what he's on the screen.
What page?
Page 11, paragraph 2.4. Graham was born Golden Bull Award. So much
from the Plain English Society.
Plain English Society.
We are. There is only meant to be one. So it's my apology to you. There is only meant to be one integrating.
Okay, well, I think that's me. It was worth coming just for that one. Okay, over to you, Abby.
I'm going to be double integrating too.
Just to add to what Greg said, Chair, as you're aware, we developed what's called the Strategic Commissioning Board group that oversees who purchases. I'm very proud that today, since we're giving the schools an opportunity to develop something in the way which has caused quite a lot of anxiety in the sector to many bodies like the CCGs. Just to remind everyone that the resources that we're talking about are not new resources, this is not new money, and these are money that are currently being used for health services. So we have to be innovative in linking this against existing areas and existing areas of activity and initiatives that we will come back to and which are priorities for our health and social care economy. For example, working 7 days and 7 days across primary care, 7 days across social services, community services, etc., which will have an impact, real impact on A&E and need to be in mind that this comes with targets, and we have a target of achieving 50% reduction in energy activity and 50% reduction in emergency activity. So, and it also has we have developed a risk sharing arrangement with one of the three companies that we agreed at the beginning that there is a potential risk that the assumptions behind this, if they do not materialize, and we have made some arrangements of how we mitigate against those and what contingency arrangements we need to put in place. And finally, I want to say is that apart from achieving the performance that is actually in 2015-16, if we do not achieve some of the targets, it's actually a negative effect of actually saying you will have the health and social care economy to lose
Okay. Over to you.
Okay. So maybe if that could attend it wrong, which is that it just feels a very good thing that I would say that touch on some of these foundations of cancer. So background of really wide line, just to give you the headline, clearly drive this by integrating health and care. We have got there. what we've tried to do is to say, from our current 256, we have some existing teams which are going through there, which you can set up and set down, which includes intermediate care, re-ablement, transitional beds, and so on. We want to continue investing in the care of parents. We've got a badge, a label at the moment around meeting the eligibility criteria that is really about protecting social care around auxiliary re-ablement, etc. Things like that. The crisis response service is the integrated discharge team based at the acute hospital, and we see that it would be absolutely critical to ensuring we've got coordinated discharge for those people who do still end up in hospital. Care and support bill. We've obviously got a lot of work to do in patient care about preparing for care and support bill. And that is around looking at the cap on care costs, actually increasing capacity for the increased assessments, care assessments on the board have a number of other things to go into the assessments at one point. Several joint posts primarily focused around supporting mental health services and dementia services, which we see as a key priority. Telehealth system technology, again, is absolutely a critical part of the work we need to continue with, and community equipment adaptations. The joint finance schemes is something that we will be reviewing, and a small amount of spend, but probably that's around the work that's done to work with the residential sector and providers primarily across health and social care. So those are the existing schemes that we feel the core community needs. Sarah and I have worked with a number of people to look at what we can decommission, and we've pretty much identified about £500,000 of current spend in the 2006 that we can decommission and reinvest. So I don't know if you want to go on to another there to invest in.
So as we go, as we carry on going down the list, we get into the broad areas where we want to invest in 15, 16 and also further. modelling financial capacity, and also Jeffrey's mentioned the contingency element of that expense, which is obviously happening. And that is your total breakdown of the spending, 14-15 and 15-16, with the proviso that in the next time coming to you, we will see a breakdown.
Need to come back and really explore further.